All right, I'm back here for a lesson. Macros at the whiteboard. I don't know if I like that. I just keep saying it. But I just got an email from someone, from Sean, and he said, hey, can you compare macros or flexible eating to Weight Watchers? And I said, you know what, Sean? I can do you one better. I'm going to compare flexible eating to Weight Watchers and The Zone. So it's going to be a little bit of a lesson. And let me give you a full disclosure. I don't know a ton about Weight Watchers. Back in the day, I had a lot of clients when I was a personal trainer that would do it, and I know it's a point system. So I'm gonna use that as a lot of my reference, but I know that it's evolved over the years, and I think really what you have to remember is, if we look at these three things, so let's take flexible eating, which is called flexible. Let's take zone, cool, and let's take Weight Watchers. And if you look at these three things, really, the cool thing about them is they're all just different variations, different forms of weighing and measuring. So really, if you're doing one of these three things, you're a step ahead of the game. You're keeping track of how much food you're eating. Now, if we look at this, flexible eating, we're looking at macros. The zone, we're looking at blocks. And Weight Watchers, I believe you're looking at points. For flexible eating in The Zone, what they are both doing is keeping track of your macronutrients. The Zone does it in block form. With flexible eating, we do it just as a gram. And that's why, let me explain right here. If you look at a block, if we're looking at The Zone created by Dr. Barry Sears, it would be one block of carb, one block of fat, and one block of protein. It's a P. And if you look at that within there, a block of carbs is 9 grams, a block of fat is 3, and a block of protein is 7. That's the block. And now in The Zone, you would get a prescription just like you would in flexible eating, and it would say you get X amount of blocks per day. So when I started The Zone, I did 16 blocks per day. So I would get 16 of these over the course of the day. The difference between The Zone and flexible eating is you have to eat them as blocks. So we have to be eating carbs, fat, and protein in every meal. Now, the beauty of flexible eating is you don't have to do that. You know, we often say with The Zone, hey, you can have donuts, you can have bagels. The problem is you're having them in this block format, so you have to have them with protein, with carb, and fat. With flexible eating, obviously what we love about it is I can save some of my carbs for some Pop-Tarts at the end of the day. I can save some of my protein or my fat, etc. I don't have to have them together. Now, which is awesome, but I do wanna say one thing about The Zone that's really beneficial is it's all about balancing your hormone levels, and that's really cool about The Zone. So I've done The Zone in the past. Is it more challenging? I think so. Is it as sustainable? I think it's a little bit harder to sustain, which is why I no longer do it. But it does take into account balancing your insulin and your glucagon. So, cool thing to try. You don't necessarily have to do The Zone though. What you can do with flexible eating is, you know, we can take our protein, our carbs, and our fats, and let's just use some simple numbers. Say your protein is at 150, your carbs are at 250, and your fats at 75. You know, this comes out to a 40-30-30 ratio for your protein, carbs, and fat. Well, we can just say, hey, I want to divide these up equally over 5 meals, and you're balancing your protein, carbs, and fat, and then you're balancing your hormone levels by doing that. So rather than saying I'm going to save it, you can say, well, I'm going to have 30 protein, I'm going to have 50 carb, and I'm going to have 15 fat at 5 meals. And that would help you balance it. The other thing about macros versus The Zone is in flexible eating, you're taking into account every gram in every food. So for example, let's use an egg. If you have an egg, we're gonna say, well, that has 7 grams of protein, about 4 grams of fat, and 0 grams of carbs. Where in The Zone, we're gonna classify an egg as protein, not taking into account the fact that there's other macronutrients in it as well. And that's why there's some hidden calories in The Zone. We're flexible eating, we're taking into account everything. Now, again, I don't know as much about Weight Watchers, I've never done it myself, but from what I understand, it's a point system. I was gonna use the example, 22. Say you get 22 points over the course of the day. Similar to counting calories, and that's where I would classify this more as like also like you're counting calories. You just have to keep to under those 22 points. And again, feel free to comment below this if you know more about Weight Watchers than I do. So for example, you can have 22 points and you can do it all from cake. You know, if you have 22 points from cake, you might feel a little crappy the next day. You might not have as much energy, you might be hungrier. So that would be the difference. I know nowadays with Weight Watchers, the one thing I have heard is they're a little smarter with foods, you know, an apple versus a piece of cake versus a piece of chicken, how many points it has. And the other thing with Weight Watchers is based on your activity. You can earn some extra points, you can save some extra points. So again, I don't know as much about it. Here's what I will tell you. Based on my experience, based on my opinion on it, all three are great if you're starting to track quantity. It's a start. It's a jumping off point. Weight Watchers is gonna be the least accurate, but you're still quantifying. Similar to counting calories. You know, you can eat 1,400 calories a day if you're a woman trying to lose weight, but if you do 1,400 calories from all donuts versus 1,400 calories from all chicken versus 1,400 calories from a nice spectrum of multiple macronutrients, you're gonna get a different reaction in your body. The zone is great. The zone is great for balancing your hormone levels, your glucagon and your insulin levels by keeping your carbs, fat, and protein at every meal. Something to definitely consider, but my favorite, obviously, flexible eating. It takes into account everything you're eating. Every gram that goes into your body is being accounted for. Would it be great to eat them in some sort of balance every day? Absolutely, but the beauty of it is you can change that. You can have your days where you save 70 carbs for two Pop-Tarts at the end of the day and still make progress, still not feel guilty. And in my opinion, that is why flexible eating is the most sustainable of these choices. I hope that helped. Like I said, if you know more about any of these, well, you probably don't know more about flexible eating, but if you know more about specifically Weight Watchers, hit me up in the comments. If you have more questions about these different types of eating, I'd love to help out. Check it out. Hope this helps. Let me know what you think.